Welcome to Latest News. We've been covering the election a lot recently, but there are other things happening in Brighton and Hove and happening all the time that really deserve attention. And one of them is U3A, which is the University of the Third Age. It's one of the biggest charities. I assume it's a charity, Roger?
It is, yes.
It is a charity. We're going to talk about what it is and why people should join it. So first of all, I'm with Roger Wheeler, and he is one of the conveners, correct?
Yes.
Of the University of the Third Age in Brighton. But it's a national and
international,
global.
Yeah. International, global. You're completely
tell me, in a couple of sentences, tell me what it's all about and what it's for.
It was it opened in Brighton in 1985 to support people who had retired without any particular role.
Right.
They didn't know what to do. And it suits very, very well. It keeps us busy. It gives us something to do, basically.
Is it? It didn't actually start in Brighton. It presumably started somewhere else in the world.
It's a youth. U3A is the U3A Trust. It's a national trust based in London.
Okay.
It's a very big organisation.
Yeah.
Let's not pretend otherwise.
Yeah.
In Brighton, we have nearly 1,000. In Brighton and Hove, I should be careful, that we have nearly 1,000 members.
Wow.
But nationally, there are many thousands of members. And internationally, I believe it runs into millions, but I don't know.
So,
I can't be certain about that.
Yeah. So my big question is, what's it for? I mean, why does it exist? And why are you, and we're going to hear from Jim Burkett later, why are you members of it? What is it really for? What does it do?
Well, quite frankly, when I did retire, which was some years ago, I was a bit of a loose end. And a friend said, I belong to U3A. What the hell was that? I said, okay. So he was learning Spanish. I liked Spain, so I went along. Mm-hmm. And the rest is history. I became sort of involved, not deliberately, but it was fun.
Yeah. And when they say Third Age, I mean, we were talking off camera about what that is, but I would have thought Third Age was about 80, but apparently you can join when you're a lot younger.
Over 50.
Over 50.
Over 50 and not in full-time employment.
Okay, and is it male or female or all or
mixed? We have mainly, because it's a University of the Third Age, it does attract a lot of retired school teachers,
right?
Of which we have a preponderance of retired school teachers.
Yeah.
I'm not one of them.
Okay.
The majority of the members in Brighton and Hove are possibly female school teachers, retired.
Yeah, and you were saying off camera again, but more than 50% are women. Is that correct?
I would say about 70% are women. I can't be certain because I've never counted.
So essentially, you need really more men to join to
we would
make it
welcome,
more equal.
Welcome more men.
I mean, you would get to giving me the list of things. You've got pottery groups, walking, opera, wine appreciation. I mean, languages.
Lots of languages. Yes.
Yeah.
You can see shanties. You can join singing. There are five walking groups.
Yeah.
I mean, it's huge.
I mean, universities too. I mean, one of the things that people complain about most is you have to pay for them and you knock up debts of 50,000. How much debt do you knock up for the University of the Third Age?
In Brighton and Hove, it's £35 a year.
£35?
A year, and for which you can join all 70 groups.
And
so it doesn't really matter.
Roger, after 3 years, do you get a degree? Or not?
Well, I think you may need to be looked at. But certainly, no. I've been doing it now.
It's really for fun, isn't it?
It's enjoyment, and we like it. And you do learn quite a lot.
You told me again that it was the biggest self-help group in the world. So you can learn anything on it, can you?
That's what I have been told.
Yeah.
And they're not very good at PR, so therefore it could be true.
What have you learned?
A lot. I run, as I'll briefly tell you, I run the travel group, which is the travel forum, which is inordinately popular, and it's once a month, and people just come together to talk about their experiences of places around the world.
Yeah.
And in my group, which I run personally, is quite stunning in the nutch as there isn't a country in the world that one of the members hasn't been to. And I mean, not one country.
Really? Blimey.
Yeah, we can talk about any country in the world and it's personal recommendations. It works.
Yeah. And you said there's 70 groups in Brighton.
The phraseology is, careful, Bill, in as much as Brighton and Hove U3A is one of the U3As in Brighton and Hove.
Okay.
There are half a dozen other smaller U3As which specialise, and they're very small.
Okay.
We are the biggest, and there are, within Brighton and Hove U3A, there are 70 types of group you can join within this organisation.
Okay.
And that's, you know, you can, anything. So there are 70 groups. I think there's more than 70 now. It's difficult to keep up.
It seems to me slightly like sort of adult education meets a sort of a friendship group. am I right or am I wrong?
Yeah, there are social groups as well. I don't know how social they get, but
okay.
They are quite social. I don't go to them because I do have a life outside of U3A. But no, it goes on, and you can join. Literally, you can opt in and out of anything. But I dropped out of the French, and I might join French again this Saturday.
It's a bit like a real university, and when you go for a few years, you have a group, and you know them all, and you go out with them.
Oh yeah,
and it's basically the same thing then, but just a bit older.
A little bit older.
Okay.
We do have some younger members. We have some in their 60s. It's surprising, yeah.
Mm. It's great that you can say that.
Well, I'm not in my 60s anymore, unfortunately. Yeah. But it's a pretty broad spread. I think the majority of people are of a slightly more mature year, but nonetheless, quite sparky.
My producer was telling me you've got a big event coming sometime very soon.
This Saturday at the St. George's Church, we have the annual, we call it Registration Day.
Okay.
Which is once a year. You come along, anybody can come, as long as they fulfil the requirement of being over 50 and not in full-time employment. You just come along and every group, all 70 groups, will be in the church with a little table telling you what they do. And you can walk in and you can go and talk to us and join if you wish, pay your £35 and you're up and running for a year. And you can join anything.
You obviously do travel writing and you're a freelance journalist. I presume you still are. So what do you, what's the role of that on the U3A?
Well, less so. I'm technically retired from writing a couple of years ago. I still do because I have the travel forum here at the U3A, which has technically 50 members, but they're all travellers, which means they're not always here.
Yeah.
They're
travelling.
They're around the world, yes.
Yeah.
As far as the travel forum's concerned, it's a forum, which means we sit and chat once a month about where we've been, where we're going. It's not about holidays. It's about travelling. And they're all retired people who travel literally around the world frequently.
Yeah.
Two of our ladies recently went on round-the-world cruises.
Right.
And was upset they couldn't get to Tahiti. That is the level of people we are talking to.
So that's yours.
And that's my personal one.
What are the other? There's 70, you said.
Oh,
what
there
are
70.
The others?
And excuse me, I don't remember them all, but there are sea shanty singing.
Yeah.
There is, I think there's dancing. There certainly is art appreciation. There's wine. There's social groups.
Yeah.
There certainly is painting, lots of languages, Spanish, French, German, Italian.
Chinese?
Don't think
Mandarin,
so.
I think.
There
so.
Certainly is Latin.
Oh, blimey, yeah.
I know.
Amoa Massima.
Latin's become more popular these days. Strangely enough, Latin is in now. I don't know why.
No, nor do I.
It isn't something that I've done. But there are, goodness me, so many. There's crossword things and a thing called upwords, whatever that might be. I don't know.
Yeah.
But I hear all these various names.
Yeah.
But they're all very popular. And people join. And I have about 50 occasionally in my group. Some of them are very small groups.
Yeah.
The art appreciation group is quite big. Mm-hmm. They're usually around 20 or 30 people.
Right.
It just, you know, this morning we did the discussion group,
right,
which is fascinating.
Wow.
A different subject every week, and it's quite quite sparky.
Wow. Thank you. Thank you very much, Roger. We're going to have a little break now. Thank you for rejoining us at Latest TV. I'm actually now with Jim Burkett, who attends the University of the Third Age.
I do.
Tell me, why do you do that?
Well, when I retired, a lot of retired people are at a loose end.
Yeah.
And they had jobs which may be quite responsible, very social, took up an awful lot of time. And it's quite important for people when they retire to engage in social activities. And probably it's a bad thing to then to end up in the pub drinking too much. So
yeah,
a good social activity is afforded by the U3A, among other organisations.
And what attracted you personally?
Well, I first found out about it when I was having a cup of tea with somebody, and he said, oh, there's a magazine here which mentions the U3A. And I said, what's that? And I looked on the website and found there was a branch in Brighton to which I retired in 2009. And I thought this would be a good thing to occupy some of my spare time.
Was there anything particularly on that list of things that you saw on that website?
I'm a great Scrabble fan.
Okay.
And I don't really like playing Scrabble online. Playing with real people is quite entertaining, and it meets every Wednesday afternoon with a cup of tea, and people who are either extremely good, or if they're extremely good, they're still welcoming to people who might be beginners.
Still going to Brighton?
Yeah, every Wednesday afternoon.
Where is it?
It's in St. John's Church in Hove.
Okay. So Scrabblers every Wednesday afternoon?
Yes.
That's probably quite a lot of the ones in Brighton who do it, I guess.
There's other groups which apparently meet in different days and different locations.
Blimey.
It's one of the popular of the many activities that U3A provides.
Do you do others, or is that your
main
one? I
do others. I do the discussion group, and which is every Tuesday.
Yeah.
And that gives an opportunity to discuss current events.
Right.
Philosophical subjects. I must say that I don't want to put people off by the word university, because it's open to all.
I thought you meant philosophy.
In a kind of very open way, we welcome it welcomes people of all kinds.
Yeah.
And there are social groups which are purely low-key, pleasant social groups.
As Roger was saying, basically, you need a few more men. You've got mainly women.
The majority of the members comprises women. And
is that true for Scrabble?
I think so, yes. Yeah.
Right. Yeah, surprising.
And then the other one I go to is the art. Well, I haven't been for a couple of weeks, but the art appreciation is quite fascinating. And we've got the travel group run by Roger.
Yeah.
And there are about 60 or 70 other activities that people can join.
Does the art appreciation mean going to galleries and looking at art?
They do organise trips.
They do,
yes.
Yeah. Right. Okay.
And it usually ends up with a person who's got a particular interest in a particular artist giving a talk with illustrated slides and so on.
And you've been obviously doing it since, did you say 2009?
No, I think I joined about 2.5 years ago.
Oh, right, okay. So you retired to Brighton,
in 2009? Yes, part of the hectic life of London.
Yeah, okay. And then you what was the attraction of Brighton? Just lovely place? Or
It was just by accident I moved here. And
really?
In London, I used to go to the theatre an awful lot.
Yeah.
Social activities. And this is just one of the activities that interested me.
Quite near the West End too, straight up on the
Absolutely,
train. So you can get into Shaftesbury Avenue and all the shows as well.
Absolutely.
A lot of people do that, don't
they?
Yeah, is there a group for that?
I'm not sure if there is a theatre appreciation group. I think Roger's look at the website.
I'm looking at Roger and he's nodding.
He's nodding. There probably is. Yeah. But so one of the problems of the West End, as you probably know, is the stratospheric cost of
400 quid a ticket.
Unless you get on particular websites that give you previews or off-peak tickets and stuff.
Yeah, if I said 400 quid, that may not be right.
Yeah, but some are.
You might be able to get it for 40. I don't know.
So it's one of the problems.
Don't take my word for it.
One of the problems of older people is finance.
Yeah.
That people on fixed incomes.
Yeah,
with the increasing cost of living, going to the theatre, even the cinema, sometimes it puts people off because the price is so high.
And what Roger was saying also, though, is that, I mean, universities, for young people, you think, God, colossal debt.
Absolutely.
But you're paying £35 a year to go to as many things as you want.
Yes, it's a bargain.
It's a bargain, it's a bargain and three quarters, isn't it, really?
Absolutely.
Yeah. What would you like to see happen in the next year or two for the U3A? Putting you on the spot here as a
even hunter. more activities being
courses
offered.
Isn't a bad word though, because you are getting it for 35 quid a year.
Absolutely. It's a bargain.
Yeah. What courses would interest what discussion groups or what would you like to see happen personally?
Well, I think everything at the moment is covered, but isn't then it comes to a question of time because you can't attend 70 different groups, you have to be fairly selective. And I have a life as well as the U3A as well, I hope, at my advanced age.
Yeah, and generally, for the whole, across the world, it's obviously taken off in a very, very big way.
I believe it has.
So what would you like to see? What would you like? People are living longer, I believe.
Absolutely.
Do you think there's a... other things that the U3A could be doing?
I think one of the things we should be discussing is what to do about ageing, in the sense of many people are living many more decades than they used to do.
Yeah, sure.
And the society has to think about that quite seriously, about what people are doing post 65 or 70.
Yeah.
And one of the big problems is people getting older and getting dementia. And can you prevent that by...
Yeah.
Social activities or
they say you can, don't they? They say if you play people music, from their younger from their younger days,
absolutely,
then that definitely helps.
Yeah.
I believe.
Yeah,
and there's scientists. I mean, maybe Peter Kyle, he's going to be Minister of Science, and he is in the Minister of Science and Innovation.
Absolutely,
maybe there are things that he could take on board there.
Yeah,
one hopes anyway. I think, Jim, do you know when the next event is? You were saying Tuesday's, was it Wednesday for Scrabble?
Wednesday for Scrabble, which is shortly. And the last discussion group for the holidays is next Tuesday at St. George's Church.
And Roger was saying there's something on Saturday.
It's the registration day.
Registration day.
You can renew your subscription.
Okay, well, we'll try and get all those up on screen now. I'm hoping we can. People, you were saying about dementia and people in the public eye, and there's a lot of ill health people see about old people. But of course, there's a lot of old people who are absolutely fine. Ringo Starr, Mick Jagger, Bob Dylan, Willie Nelson, they are all playing, performing as good as ever. And then there's people like President Biden, there's doubts about his health. What's your view on retirement generally?
My view is that self-employed people tend to hang on much longer than people who work for an organisation, because in many organisations have a fixed retirement age, and people who want to stay on longer seem to be accused of blockers of promotion for younger people.
Yeah.
And people who are self-employed tend to hang on because they like the power, they like the way they can influence society or influence what happens, and
maybe they just like drumming.
If they're forced out by the shareholders, they feel very resentful and feel that their purpose in life is being changed. And so I think that keeping the mind active is the most important.
So your basic message is whether you're in retired, whatever you're doing, whether you're in a big job or whether you're a self-employed is just carry on. That's what you'd like to see.
Yes, carry on regardless.
Carry on regardless. What about, you know, in the police and public services, you have to retire around 50.
Correct.
I mean, that's very young,
isn't
it? Yeah,
but if you're doing a physical job like a fireman, you have to retire because it's impossible. But desk-bound jobs, there's no reason why you shouldn't carry on because people, if they have the ability, they might as well continue.
So Biden, you think basically carry on, he might have stumbled over the odd word, but who really cares? Carry on.
It's up to him. Yeah. You know, I don't know the medical details of the former vice president, of
all these people pushing around and saying all these stuff, you think that's basically ageism? Really?
It might be, but on the other hand, we need political leaders who are fully in charge of their abilities.
Wow, okay. Well, the U3A, would you think he'll be joining there anytime soon?
I think it's very good for, and don't let the word university put people off. It's for everybody who's retired.
Should
basically
be the universe of the third age.
Universe of the third age is a very good alternative description.
Yeah. Well, there you go. Thank you very much for coming in, Jim. And before that, we heard from Roger Wheeler. So the University of the Third Age, or as I prefer to call it, the Universe of the Third Age, is something you should really look at.
Yeah.